Okay, so I have this virtual machine, specifically it's Linux Mint, doesn't really matter. And if I check the size of its disk, we can see that in the root mount point, we have this partition, basically the main partition, and its size is about 21 gigabytes. So that's what we want to enlarge. We want to have a bigger virtual disk. So first we need to turn off the virtual machine. Let's do that. Then we need to make sure that we don't have snapshots in the virtual machine. So to do that, we open the snapshots view over here. And we can see that for me, I don't have any snapshots. If your virtual machine does have snapshots, it may interrupt the process of enlarging the disk. So I highly recommend that you make sure that you don't have any snapshots. And if you do, delete them. Next, we need to open the details of the virtual machine over here, the details icon. Then we need to select VIRT.io disk 1. That's this one. And we're going to need in a second the source path of the disk. That's the path we see over here. So we can triple click on it, then copy it. And now we're ready to actually run the command that will actually increase the disk size. So let's open our terminal. And here is the command that we're going to need. Let's copy it and paste it to the terminal. And of course, we need to replace path to virtual disk with a path to our actual virtual disk. So let's copy the path again and paste it as the path to our virtual disk. Then we need to specify by how much we want to enlarge our disk. So here I have 20 gigabytes written. So I want additional 20 gigabytes. That works fine for me, but if you want more than 20 gigabytes or less than that, you know, go ahead and change it. For me, it works fine, so I'll hit enter. And we can see image resized. Let's now get back to our virtual machine and restart it. And let's open the virtual machine in full screen. It will be more convenient to see. Okay, we now need to open the terminal in the virtual machine. And here we need to run ls block. And we get a list of our disks and partitions in these disks. So for me, I only have one disk. I also have the virtual optical drive, but apart from that, I only have one virtual disk, VDA. And in VDA, I have three partitions, VDA1, VDA2, and VDA3. So VDA3 has the root mount point. And we can see that even though we enlarged the disk itself, the size of the partition didn't change yet. So it's still what it used to be. So to fix that, we're going to install Cloud Guest Utils. So let's update our system and install Cloud Guest Utils. And now that we have that installed, we can use grow part, and this will grow the main partition. So here's the command. And of course, you will have to change the name of your disk and partition. So for me, it is VDA. So VDA, that's what we have written here. And the partition that we want to resize is the main partition, partition 3. So that's why I have 3 written here. If in your case, this 3, the structure over here is a bit different, you might have to change either the name of the disk or the number of the partition. For me, as you can see, the name of the disk is VDA and the partition is partition 3. So after we make sure this is okay, let's hit enter. And our partition was stretched to utilize the entire disk space. If we run ls block now, we can see that VDA3 uses the additional 20 gigabytes. The last thing we need to do is to resize the file system. To do that, we run this command. And again, you might have to change the name of the partition. So we already saw that for me, it's VDA3. The name of the partition is VDA3. If in your case, the name is different, you will have to change it. And if we now run df-h, we can see that the size of the main partition was updated, and we now have access to the additional 20 gigabytes in this partition.